Were you recently diagnosed with an inflammatory arthritis or an autoimmune disease? Did your doctor say anything about a treatment with biologics? What are biologics? Let's find out in this lecture. In the 1990s, researchers made a huge step in understanding our immune system and the role of the immune system in many inflammatory arthritis and autoimmune diseases. In this lecture, we will talk about what are biologics, how do biologics work, what are the most common classes of biologic medication that we use in rheumatology, what laboratory tests you should have before starting on biologics, what should you consider in preparation for biologics therapy, and what are the most common risks associated with the use of biologics. Before I start, I would like to make this disclaimer. This video is for educational purpose only and will not substitute medical evaluation by a physician. For any medical advice, please contact your physician. And in case of an emergency, please call 911 immediately. What are biologics? Biologics are sophisticated therapies that are designed to target molecules that are causing inflammation. Many of these molecules are monoclonal antibodies, which means they are proteins or antibodies that target inflammatory molecules, and that will decrease the amount of inflammation in the patient's body. In normal situations, inflammation is a natural response of our immune system to stop a virus or bacteria that is attacking our body. However, in certain situations like autoimmune diseases, the inflammation goes on and becomes destructive for our own body. How do biologics work? As I said, biologics are antibodies designed to stop molecules that are causing inflammation. Researchers have designed biologics that will block either receptors on a cell that produces inflammation or block inflammatory molecules that are floating in our body or in our joints. Let me give you an example. Adalimumab, which is commercially known as Humira, is a TNF-alpha inhibitor that will block the TNF-alpha molecule in the blood, but also in the joints. Etanercept, which is commercially known as enbrel, will block the receptors on the cells where the TNF-alpha is supposed to bind. What are the most common classes of biologics that we use in rheumatology? There are many classes of biologics that we use in rheumatology. For the purpose of this lecture, I will include only the ones that we use most frequently for patients with inflammatory arthritis like rheumatoid arthritis, ankylosing spondylitis, or psoriatic arthritis. Again, this lecture is for educational purpose only, and it doesn't give you medical advice. Also, I'm not advertising any of these drugs. You should discuss your clinical situation with your physician and make a decision about what medication is appropriate for your case. The most commonly used biologics are TNF-alpha inhibitors, such as adalimumab, etanercept, infliximab, sertolizumab, or golimumab. These drugs can be used either alone or in combination with methotrexate, which is another drug that we commonly use in rheumatology. The combination of TNF inhibitor and methotrexate appears to be superior to either one used alone. Another class of medication is called IL-6 inhibitors. IL-6 is another cytokine that is involved in creating inflammation. Currently, we have two IL-6 inhibitors on the market called tocilizumab and sarilumab. Both of these medications are used in rheumatoid arthritis patients. For patients suffering from psoriatic arthritis or ankylosing spondylitis, it was shown that IL-17 is a molecule involved in creating more inflammation. More recently, researchers developed IL-17 inhibitors such as secukinumab or ixekizumab. These drugs have been proven to work both for the skin, like skin psoriasis, and also for the joint disease. There are also other biologics that block the interleukin-12 or interleukin-23 or both of these at the same time, like ustekinumab or guselkumab. These are currently used for psoriasis and psoriatic arthritis. In a separate lecture, I will talk about small molecules or JAK inhibitors and their role in treating patients with inflammatory arthritis. What laboratory tests you should have before starting biologics? Before starting on a biologic medication, it is crucial to have a full evaluation of your disease and obtain certain blood tests such as cell counts, your renal and hepatic panel, markers of inflammation, your TB or tuberculosis status, hepatitis B, and hepatitis C. These medications can potentially lower your immune system, and that can cause activation or reactivation of an infection like tuberculosis. If you do have latent tuberculosis, you should be treated or at least start treatment for at least 3 months before you start on a biologic treatment. What should you consider in preparation for biologic therapy? You should also consider getting up to date on your vaccines. The recommended vaccines are flu vaccine, pneumococcal vaccine, shingles vaccine, and now more recently, COVID-19 vaccine. What are the most common risks associated with the use of biologics? As I said, biologics are powerful drugs that will lower your immune system to a certain degree. There are some side effects that I extensively educate my patients about. These are infections and injections or infusion site reactions. Based on the latest research, it appears that the risk for infection is higher in the first 6 to 12 months of therapy, especially for TNF inhibitors. Infections like sinusitis, otitis, or other upper respiratory infections are common in patients with this type of therapy. More severe infections that will require hospitalizations were reported at an incidence rate of 2 to 8 per 100 patient years. Patients with evidence of hepatitis B require monitoring of the viral loads while treating them with these drugs. In patients with hepatitis C, it is preferred to have the treatment for hepatitis C before starting on a biologic medications. There is also an increased risk for shingles, especially in patients taking glucocorticoids like prednisone or other forms of steroids or another type of immunosuppressive drug. Another frequent question that I receive from my patients is related to the risk of developing malignancies such as lymphoma or non-melanoma skin cancers. Unfortunately, carrying a disease like rheumatoid arthritis will increase the risk of cancer up to 10 to 15 times. Many patients also take other medications that will increase the risk of cancers. Many studies that look at the efficacy of biologics, they exclude patients with cancer from their trials. That is why it is very difficult to see if the addition of biologics such as TNF inhibitors actually increases the risk for malignancy. However, we do have access to a few meta-analyses and studies from Europe that show that the risk is similar in people with and without the biologic therapies or with the TNF inhibitors versus methotrexate therapy. Multiple large population and registry-based studies from various countries, including the United States, United Kingdom, Sweden, Denmark, and France have actually failed to demonstrate an increased risk of lymphoma among patients treated with TNF inhibitors. They compare patients that were treated with the TNF inhibitor with the same disorder, most of the time they were patients with rheumatoid arthritis, with patients that were not treated with these agents. When it comes to the risk of non-melanoma skin cancers, unfortunately, there has been evidence of increased risk among patients treated with TNF inhibitors. More limited studies have suggested a possible increase in malignant melanoma. That is why, in all my patients, I do recommend to have a skin exam every year and to apply sunscreen every time when they are outside in the sun. Other side effects reported were demyelinating disease or an increased risk of heart failure. If you are concerned about the disease in our area of expertise, I urge you to go to be evaluated by a rheumatologist that will be able to make a proper diagnosis and treatment for you. If you like the content of these educational videos, please consider to like, share, or subscribe to my channel. Thank you. Rheumatologistoncall.com